Keeping colleagues engaged and on task throughout a workshop or presentation can be tricky, especially when it's online. Now, if you're looking for ways to encourage interaction and collaboration during your next meeting, stay tuned. I'm going to show you how to use whiteboards in Canva to ensure that everyone's on the same page and actively participating in all sorts of activities. Hey, I'm Matt and I'm from Canva Design School. I love working from home, but I do miss that ease of facilitating face-to-face meetings. Like, I like having that big board, the markers and the sticky notes at my disposal. I can initiate impromptu brainstorming activities and collaboration tasks. So with Canva's whiteboarding feature, I couldn't be more thrilled. Not only does it provide endless sticky notes and space for group work, but it allows me to add a range of templates and help develop and organize ideas on the spot. Before I go any further, make sure you subscribe to our channel. That way you can learn tips and tricks like this and more. All right, time to show you what I've created. Here's a presentation I pulled together for a team debrief. It looks like an ordinary slide deck, but some of these pages have been altered so the outer section actually becomes a whiteboard. To make any page into a whiteboard, you just need to select the background, right click, then hit expand to whiteboard. Now you can place elements into this section without them disappearing. And as you can see, the elements panel has also changed. Now I have easy access to sticky notes, stickers, and shapes to build mind maps and flowcharts. Later, I'll show you how to section off the different areas for different tasks and teams, but for now, let me walk you through what else I've included in this presentation. As I've mentioned before, this has been designed to facilitate a debrief session after a family fun day. To ease everyone in and highlight the purpose of the meeting, I've added an intro page and some objectives. Now we're onto the serious stuff, feedback data. The information on this slide provides the perfect opportunity to lead into a reflection activity. While I could build my own, I'm going to see if there's a template I can use instead. I'll just go up here, and I'll search for team debrief, and perhaps I'll try this one. Yeah, this is perfect. It's got all the prompts up the top and sticky notes ready for people to write on. I'll just resize it and move it over here. Now, if I was a facilitator, I'd start by getting everyone to explore the feedback on the slide and then jump over to the reflection activity. I'd invite them to fill out each section individually and then discuss the responses as a group. That way, no matter whether they're an extrovert or an introvert or something in between, they'll be able to have some type of say. Now, let's check out this next slide. This time, I want the group to explore post-event marketing opportunities. To help make this happen, I'm going to set up a brainstorming station with sticky notes. First, I'll add a shape so it's easy for everyone to identify it when they zoom out. It'll also act as a boundary to keep people working within this space. Next, I'll add some instructions. Let's say we want participants to generate as many ideas as possible in under 5 minutes. We'll ask them to aim for quantity over quality to encourage creativity and bold thinking. And perhaps I'll pop a little reminder here that no idea is a bad idea. And finally, I'll add a couple of sticky notes for them to get started. They can either copy and paste these or add more from the elements panel. Actually, I might even add a little copy me here so it's super clear what they need to do. To add text, just double click and the cursor will appear. If I have more than 5 people joining the meeting, I might want them to work in smaller groups. I can easily duplicate this and move the copies to other areas of the page. The only thing I'll change now is the color of the background shape. That way, it'll be easy to direct people to the section that I want them to work on. All right, there's one more thing I'd like to add here, and that's an impact effort matrix. It's a design thinking tool that's handy for determining whether ideas are going to be the most effective and feasible. Canva has a ton of templates just like this to aid group work and design thinking. So to add my effort impact matrix, I'll search here. Once I select the design I want, I'll move it over here and make some quick changes. First, I'll change this to say top ideas. That way I can ask teams to select their five best to bring across. We'll start with all the ideas in this box and then discuss them one by one and plot them over on this chart. The idea here is to identify the ideas with the highest impact and the lowest effort. It's a great exercise to help remove bias from certain ideas and assess each one based on its own merit. All right, let's say that the team has now figured out which ideas they want to execute. They have decided that they want articles and photos to feature in a bunch of different media outlets. Now it's time to create an action plan to make sure it happens. On this final page, I want to add a Kanban board. If you haven't used one before, it's basically a template that helps you visualize what needs to get done. As you can see, it's a very visual way to identify and track the progress of tasks. You can even add photos of each team member so it's obvious who's in charge of what. This can be a really handy tool if you're required to oversee projects and keep tabs on everyone's responsibilities. And it's helpful for team members too, as it keeps them accountable and on task. All right, I think this presentation is ready to be shared. To do that, I'll need to head up here, click share, then change the options. I'll make sure it's set to anyone with the link and allow for editing. Now I can copy this link and send it out via email, or I could just drop it into the chat box once everyone's arrived. And that's how you use the whiteboard tool to get everyone actively participating in your next online meeting. It couldn't be simpler. If you're still here, I'm guessing you found this video helpful, or at least I hope you did. Let me know in the comments what you intend to use the whiteboard tool for and whether you plan on using the templates to spice up those presentations. Make sure you like this video to ensure others see it too, and why not subscribe while you're at it? See you next time.